Let's talk about the Los Angeles Lakers, because good Lord, this has been a wild week for them and for their leader and really the face of the NBA, LeBron James. LeBron reportedly stormed out of that Wednesday night player meeting that involved every player inside the NBA bubble, and then some gamers got online and they saw LeBron playing Madden and NBA 2K, which is not a good sign if you're leaving a meeting about racial injustice and what the NBA should do moving forward, and then you go and play video games. I don't know about that one, LeBron. It's up to you. But LeBron also voted, hey, we should just call this thing and call it early. Now, if you want to go ahead and add LeBron on whatever gaming system you play on, Strive. Oh, this is on Xbox. Just been told. This is on Xbox. I add him at Strive for G8, which is a greatness, 23. You know, if you want to, great. Maybe you'll catch him in a lie. Maybe you'll catch him playing when he shouldn't be playing. Now, this is what Shams Charania had to say about LeBron leaving that meeting early, and this really cleared a lot up. I know I was just hating on LeBron a little bit, but truly this clears it up. Shams said LeBron James walked out of Wednesday's player meeting because he supported the Bucks, supported the boycott, but there was no plan. For James, actions and outcomes mattered the most. Otherwise, why did they do any of this? He became comfortable to play once the NBA Players Association mapped out a purpose and a plan. So that's good for LeBron. I'm glad he left for the right reasons. He didn't just leave just because he was mad. He was just mad because there was no plan. And that actually makes a lot of sense to me. The Bucks decided to sit out without any further action getting ready to take place. And then they got it figured out, and the NBA and the NBA Players Association have come up with an agreement to kind of get this ball rolling and to get the games back on track. Now, if you are a Lakers fan, and I know we have so many of them that watch here on Chat Sports, go ahead and join the best and fastest growing Lakers community on all of YouTube. YouTube.com/LakersTV. I'm doing videos almost every single day. We've got people all around Chat Sports that do Lakers stuff and are talking about your Los Angeles Lakers whenever you want, on demand, 24/7. So go hit that subscribe button. We just passed 16K, I'm pretty sure. Let's go ahead and get up to 20K. Might as well do it. YouTube.com/LakersTV. Now, the Lakers do have a playoff series that they still need to be in the right mindset for. You've got the Blazers and you got the Lakers. But the Lakers have a commanding 3-1 lead. Damian Lillard's out for game 5, however, because of that knee injury. We'll talk about him more here in just a second. But game 5, win or go home for the Blazers, and lose, or I guess go to the second round for the Los Angeles Lakers. When you look at how the games have played out so far, the Blazers won that first one by 7 points. And all of a sudden, people were kind of like, whoa, maybe the Blazers can make some noise here. Well, not so fast, my friend, as Lou Holtz would say. Right, Lou Holtz? No. Who says not so fast, my friend? Lee Corso, that's who it is. Game 2, 111-88 with the Lakers winning that one. And then Game 3, another 8-point victory. And then Game 4 was just pure dominance. Damian Lillard went down with that knee injury, and the Lakers won by 20 points. The Lakers have this wrapped up because there's no Damian Lillard. He's gone from the bubble. He left to get that knee looked at, which swelled up so bad that he could not even bend it properly. And now you go ahead and see what the Blazers have, and it ain't that pretty. You got Winion Gabriel now starting alongside Gary Trent Jr. That's a starting power forward, and you're starting two guards. CJ McCollum probably slides to the point with Melo and Yusuf Nurkic. I'm afraid it's just not going to get it done, and I'm afraid the Portland Trail Blazers are going to be going home in just 5 short games. Lakers lead this 3-1. It's basically over. But now the question and their sights start to turn on the NBA Finals. Should the Lakers be considered the favorite to win it all? Let me know down below in the chat. Type Y for yes, type N for no. I go back and forth on the Lakers and the Clippers. As of right now, I think I'm leaning Lakers, but just the other day I was leaning Clippers, so you can convince me either way. If you say yes, make your case in the comments.